Good morning. Sorry, my glasses are fogging up. It's about 16 degrees out. It's supposed to get actually pretty warm today. So I am wearing layers. But we're out in the woods. We're going to film, I guess, what I'm going to call a mini-series. And it is going to consist of building a permanent shelter. My goal is to basically have it be a kind of like a cabin, I guess. I want it to be completely enclosed with a roof, and I'm gonna hopefully improvise some kind of a door, and eventually I will bring my big turkey truck. Eventually I will bring my sorry, brain fart. Just looking at all the trails and stuff out here. All the different animal tracks, coyotes, everything. I'm out of breath. Everything seems to be converging right here. It's kind of weird. All those tracks. Anyways, bring my little camp stove out there, and so I can do a couple of videos and keep it nice and warm in there. So we're gonna keep going this way a little bit. I got a rough idea where I want to start this, so we will see you then. Well, I think this is going to be the spot here. I can, like I said, I kind of want to build this like a log cabin. So I needed four trees somewhat close to each other to tie off to and stack to and everything like that. Or I might just run a ridge pole, and then I could build sides up it and kind of run it. No, I want it level. I want it about, you know, a couple inches higher than me. So I can do this a couple of different ways. I can do a number like this, a little triangle, and build three walls and a door somewhere. I don't really have a plan. You know, I was hoping to find... All right, sorry, battery got cold. So we're gonna run a ridge line from there to there. We're gonna come back, we're gonna come here to this tree, and then here. So it's gonna be somewhat squarish, I guess you could call it. But first thing we gotta do, that branch right there, it's dead. We gotta knock that down before we do anything. So, got my cheap axe. This is going to be a good piece of firewood. Excuse me. All right, that's out of the way. We got a Trim this a little bit, get it out of the way for now. Not going to be our ridge pole. That is something we need to go find. Ideally, this piece of iron would be great. Maple, but it's alive. That sure shall stay. There we go. Found something to make a nice ridge pole. Right there. I'm not gonna go all the way through yet. Holy cow. The reason I call that ironwood. Holy smokes. Jesus. Whew. Okay, now we're gonna come back. You know, leave them. Put you in on focus. Sorry, out of breath.
I'm okay, fine breath.
There we go. Whew. Yeah, so it's almost New Year. Here's my resolution. Get back in shape. Holy cow, we'll come back for that. Holy cow.
There. Okay, so this is the main ridge pole, I guess you could call it. We're gonna do this shelter a little bit different. I wanna put this, I'm gonna build a little wall back there, probably about, I don't know, yay high, so 4 feet or so. Then we're gonna run roof trusses, if that's what you wanna call them. And then we're gonna build up the sides. And we're gonna build the front. I'm gonna have a little door right here. And my bed will be back there. And I'll be able to put the wood stove right here or right here, depending. So, yeah. Whew. Have I mentioned yet that I'm a skosh out of shape? So, I'm gonna lose these glasses here for a minute because I keep fogging up, making it difficult to see. Okay, found some rope finally. All right, so I don't really have anything to crawl on. This might be a pain. Twice. Okay, so this is going to be interesting. I'm going to try to hold this in place and hold my pole, my Canadian jam knot tight. So another thing I can do too is prop this up, which I will probably. All right, I got a feeling I'm gonna end up taking that down and redoing it, but I just need to get it up there so I can get the other end up there. To do this end, and I do got to take a couple of branches off real quick. These little ones. There. Okay, we're gonna attempt to do the same thing at this end. Make a Canadian jam knot, which is a little loop and a knot. And you feed this through and around . Put our gloves back on real quick. There we go. Do this before that battery dies. They don't like the cold. It's the only downfall of this camera is it's not cold friendly. Hey, that is higher than my head, so that is where we want those. Okay, so that's going to be the start of everything. I'll latch these a little bit better, and we're going to start building back there. But so those of you that know, I had some pigs I raised, had them butchered, got some side pork. Side pork basically is uncured, unsmoked bacon, so it's completely plain. So I brought some Montreal. I'm gonna get a fire going and just kinda slowly smoke it myself, if that makes sense, I guess. But yeah, so that's the game plan. So I'm gonna let this sit here for a minute, and then we're gonna gather up some wood and get a smoky fire going. And I'm gonna do the kinda spit method, where I got the stick and I just hang it and just let it really cook, slow cook in that smoke. So we'll see you here in a bit. So I love about a lot of snow, the ground's still soft. So when I go to pound steaks in the ground, they're gonna stay soft, or they're gonna go right in. So this is where we're gonna build our fire. I'm gonna go grab a couple of Y-shaped sticks to stick in the ground to get a good reference of what I need. So we will be back. Okay, so a couple of sticks here. A little better. Oh, biscuit. There. That'll work. Gotta make this a little.
So, unfortunately, I'm nowhere near any birch bark. There's not a birch tree within half a mile of me, or at least. So,
I got some maple and some other stuff, and we're gonna attempt to build a feather stick, I guess, out of the maple. I don't know how well it's going to work. Man, my nose is just a running. Some decent little curls on there. There we go. Get a little better positioned here. This feels wet. Do not have this kind of wood to make some good curls. That looks a little bit better, huh? All right, so I got some maple, little tiny twigs. Only problem is everything's got ice on it because we had freezing fog this morning. It's still a little bit foggy out. You don't see it so much in the woods, but yeah, it is. So we're gonna put these in my pocket for a minute. Kind of thaw them out. Because it is going to be difficult to get a fire going with everything being so wet. this one birch tree.
Well, that's disappointing. All right, I think we're going to have to cheat on this one and use a piece of the paper that the side pork's wrapped in. Everything is just covered in ice, and I don't have any birch bark or anything like that. So, yeah. No, I'm not overly excited about doing it this way, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. If this were a real survival situation and not just a goofy show, so Pete's even that's not wanting to go. Holy cow. Smokes, man. Hopefully that'll at least dry it off some, huh? Crap. I've never had this big of an issue trying to light a fire. Oh.
Excuse me. There, so we're gonna let that burn down a little bit. I just wanna get a really good bed of coals, and then I'm gonna put a little bit damper wood on it to get the smoke a lot. So. Knees are frozen. Oh man. Whew. That was a pain. All right. So we're gonna get the side port going. I've never had this before, but I hear it's really good. So, for those of you that don't know, basically side pork is bacon, as you can see, but it's not smoked or cured. And this is a thicker cut bacon, too. Setting the package on fire. Smoke. Holy crap. It's definitely gonna be smoky. That's why I'm doing the fire like this, is so I can smoke my side pork myself. And as you can tell how I'm gagging here, it's definitely smoky. So There's no smoke, there's no seasoning, nothing like that. So I'm going to put some good old-fashioned Montreal steak seasoning on it. As the smoke continues to burn my eyes. Holy cow, that's smoky. Make my eyes water. Okay, so yeah, that should work. And this is going to be a very slow process because I want that smoke to really get in there. The smokiness, the smoky flavor, whatever you want to call it. And this is from a pig I raised over the fall. So it should hopefully be really good. Whew, man, definitely smoky. Okay, so I'm gonna This fire moved just a little bit. Hot. There.
Man. Ugh, right in my eyes.
All right, so we're going to let that slow cook. While we're doing that, I'm going to move because the smoke is killing me. And we're going to talk about the sponsor of my show, of this episode. So we're going to set that right there for now. Okay, so, sponsor of the show is Copper Trail Brewing Company out of Alexandria, Minnesota. I got a Runestone rye beer. I've had a couple of theirs, and they have been very good. So, I got my little 3D printed Kuksa, I think is how you say that. And we're going to crack this bad boy open and, oh yeah, got a nice head on it. That is very good. So they're on Facebook and, you know, they're on, they've got a webpage. I'll, put the link in the, description of the video. And so that way you guys can go and check them out. These are giant cans. Sounds like they're coming out with a, 12-ounce six-pack cans coming out pretty soon. So that's pretty cool. But, yeah, just check them out. Look them up on Facebook. It's Copper Trail Brewing Company, or Copper Trail Brewing. And, yeah, they make some really good beers. Definitely frothy. So we're gonna let the bacon cook here, and then we're gonna get back to working on the shelter. So I'm gonna set this right here so it stays nice and chilled, and we're gonna finish drinking it out of the little kuksa. Okay, so bacon's still slow cooking. What we're gonna do, take my old chill grill tarp here, and we're gonna kind of just slightly overlap it a little bit and tie it to the ridge pole, and then there we go. So that way we've got a semi-waterproof roof. There's a big hole in it, but I can cover that up with something. That's gonna be kind of the roof, so we're gonna see how far back this goes, and then we'll know where to put our back wall. I'm still gonna put side walls on it, and mostly close in the front. And that's roughly the angle I want it, so that's good, right there. Yep. All right, so I'm gonna take and I'm gonna grab you guys real quick here. Oops, sorry. That bacon, just slow cooking. It's not really slow cooking anymore. I gotta adjust that real quick.
that smoking some more. So, anyways, we're going to take in the center one here. We're going to tie that on too. So that way it stays kind of overlapped. Okay, so that's that. Now we're gonna start building the back wall, and this is gonna be the slightly challenging part. I think I'm gonna drive a couple of tall stakes into the ground first, there and there, to tie the tarp to, and that way I know how high I've got to put my wall. I think I'm gonna go one log above and try to put it tight up against the back there. To block the wind and everything from coming in, because my bed's going to be right here. Probably going to put my wood stove, because I think I'm going to put my head there because it kind of runs downhill. And so I'll probably put my wood stove over in that side. And I got to build wall. And I'm going to build most of a wall. I'm just going to have just a little door, which I'll probably just get a small tarp to be able to close it and everything, because I want this thing sealed. So when I come out here and do some camping trips when it's really cold, you know, it's not that bad, I guess. I mean, I'll have my sleeping bag and everything, and, you know, hopefully I'll be able to get all the snow out of here. I need to get a snow shovel to bring with the next time. But we're going to get going on that, so we'll be back. Okay, so I went and got two poles. These are going to be my stakes I pounded into the ground. Probably a little high, or tall rather. Okay, so I can trim this down a little bit. Guys over here. I think that'll work. I'm gonna do the same to this one here.
Hello, you can see me.
Okay, this one's gonna have to be trimmed down too. But first thing we're gonna do is tie this off over there so I know how far to put it apart. So you know, I haven't really that much of a breeze out, but this tarp is so light that it feels like there is. Okay, it's just kind of a hook tie job. There, so yeah, I can cut this off quite a bit. I want to get a bigger saw, like a buck saw. Yeah, this is nice for cutting small wood and stuff like that, but not the best.
Where do we go here?
You guys watch.
How's that sound? That should hold. I'm gonna take a piece of the string, the rope rather. Okay, this tree's a little bit in the way, but that's fine. So, yeah. And I think once I get my wall going or whatever, I'm gonna put something here. Yeah, I'll let you guys see in here.
Look what I can do. So anyways, I think I'll put something down the middle here to just kind of hold it up, you know. I'll probably do something like this. Just maybe even just stick a pole in there to help hold it up so the snow and everything kind of goes that away. But we gotta check on the bake and be right back.
That'll be good enough. Okay, so I did put it up a little bit higher than the other ones, just because I kind of want to pitch to it. There's that. Now, bacon's still cooking, by the way. So now we gotta start getting logs to line up on the back. I want to come all the way up to here, so I'm gonna need 3 more stakes to help keep it from teeter-tottering, but we'll get the first couple of logs down first and then base it off that. Yeah. Number one, 15 to go. Okay, so I got thinking, if I make this thing 10 foot by 12 foot and that big, that's quite a bit of space to heat up. So I think what I'm going to do is shrink it by half. So I'm gonna pound a steak on each side, fold the tarp down, and that'll be like that. Then I just gotta do the sides and the front. Reason I'm doing that is heat. Because if I do it the way I was going to originally, it's going to be quite a bear to heat. I'm gonna be going through a lot of firewood. And granted, I got a really nice sleeping bag and everything, but that's not what I want to do. So we're going to untie this. We're going to put it on here. Oops. There we go. And we're going to take and move this pole and so on and so forth. Oh, the bacon's looking good. Put a little bit sharper edge or point on this too.
So,
I'm at this right about here, I think.
I wish that tree wasn't there.
Oh well. So, yeah, we'll just do this. I can pull it tighter that way. So, there you go. We're gonna take and pound this into the ground. Okay, one down, three to go.
Oops, sorry. Oh, that side pork. Oh, that looked good. Shortly. Okay, so now I'm gonna put something special right there. Gives it a nice pitch, huh? Hope that'll stay there for a second. While I get this knot ready. That'll give me a little bit of a vent at the top, too. Canadian jam knot. There, that is good and tight. Just for good measure. I gotta figure out some kind of knot for the back. Okay, so I'm going to run a pole like this. So I've got something to tie the wall to. So maybe we'll even do it like this. That's a little dramatic, but you know. Yeah. Now we'll do it like this. Okay, so set this down. Get a length of rope. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna show you guys how to do this. So you put a loose loop in it. And you tie a knot. Anyways, you do that, and then you put it around whatever you're tying. That you pull that tight, pulls tight on itself, and yeah, it's a really good knot. This like this real quick to just to hold it here for a minute. There. Gosh, dang it. This one didn't pull tight right for some reason. Boy, doesn't that make me look a fool. That should be good and tight. There. Now. Excuse me. I can start lining up branches. Fun we have. Two. 25 to go. Well, got that much done, but it's time to start eating this bacon. It's starting to get a little crispy. So, that's hot. Hot. Son of a biscuit. Wow, I grow a good pig. That's good. Wind shipping. Smoke's getting in my eyes. Driving me nuts. Tell you what. This right here pairs very nicely with that right there. But, yeah. Copper Trail Brewing Company there in Alexandria, Minnesota. Really good. I've already mentioned it, but I'll say it again. They're today's sponsor. All right, that's good. I'm not gonna make you guys sit here and watch me borrow this half a pound of bacon, or side pork, sorry. I tell you, there's a something about it being your own. You know, it. I raised that, grew it, whatever you wanna say. I didn't grow it because I didn't plant it. But, I mean, it's just, that's the best bacon I've ever had. All right, there we go. Well, I got the one side done for the most part. I think next time we come out, we'll do the other side and maybe part of the front. Excuse me. I want to do a little bit more stuff on the back. I think I'm going to run another ridge line. Here, I'll even bring you with me so you can actually see what I'm talking about. So I think we'll run another ridge line once I get that other side built up. From here to here, and I think we're gonna go like this with some sticks and logs and whatnot, just to get a little bit of a barrier. I'm gonna cut that tail off next time I'm out, and then I think what we'll do when we do finally get it ready to camp in, I'll bring my big blue chill gorilla tarp, and we'll just wrap it around just to give it that extra, you know, windproof. That's probably a word. But yeah, we'll do that. And then we'll bring out the sleeping bag and the wool blankets and a tarp to lay on the ground and the wood stove and do an overnight out here. Probably cook a pork chop even. But again, this is Ryan with Ryan Outdoors. I appreciate you tuning in. If you haven't already, please subscribe. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and hit the little bell, bell icon so you can get notifications on future videos. And again, this video was brought to you by Copper Trail Brewing Company out of Alexandria, Minnesota. Their website will be in the description, or their link to their website. So thank you again. See you next time.